You ever notice how algae shows up the moment you think your tank finally looks perfect? Like, you clean the glass, trim the plants, fix the flow, and the next morning, the algae is like, "Hey, I heard you wanted to practice patience today." Yeah, we've all felt that pain. But here's the truth most beginners never hear. Algae is almost never just algae. It's a symptom. It's your tank trying to tell you something. And when you follow the wrong advice, especially the classic, just get algae eaters advice, you end up fixing the surface problem while the real problem keeps growing underneath it. That's exactly what we're breaking down today. The real beginner trap, the hidden mistakes that cause almost every algae bloom, and the actual science behind why algae takes over tanks that look fine on the outside. And listen, before we dive in, hit that subscribe button. Seriously, if algae has ever humbled you, embarrassed you, or made you question every decision in your life, you're in the right place. We learn, we fix, we laugh, and somehow our tanks end up better than before. And don't swim off early, because at the end of this video, we're breaking down three huge algae myths and two scientific truths that will completely change how you think about algae, biofilm, and tank stability. Plus, if you haven't seen our previous video, Best Algae Eaters That Really Help, that one completes this guide. This video fixes the causes. The previous video gives you the cleanup crew. They work together like a perfect two-part system. Now, let's start with the mistake nearly every beginner makes. The beginner trap. Thinking algae comes from one problem. Most beginners think algae comes from one thing: too much light, or too many nutrients, or not enough water changes, or the tank just being new. But algae isn't triggered by one problem. It's triggered when the balance breaks. Plants, microbes, grazers, biofilm, and your tank's environment all work together like gears in a machine. The moment one gear slips out of rhythm, algae rushes in and fills the gap. A 2021 study in aquatic botany found that algae blooms almost always occurred when lighting, nutrients, and microbial activity became inconsistent, even in tanks that technically had good parameters. Translation: your tank doesn't need perfection, your tank needs predictability. So let's walk through the real causes, the ones science actually supports, and the ones that lead straight to algae chaos. Cause number one, light instability. Most beginners think algae comes from too much light. But the real problem? Inconsistent light. Plants and microbes adapt slowly. Algae adapts instantly. So when your lighting hours change every few days, or brightness is shifted around, or your tank gets random sunlight hits, algae takes advantage of the chaos. It's not the strength of the light that triggers algae. It's the unpredictability. Keep your lighting consistent and you eliminate half the battle. Cause number two, sudden nutrient surges. A little extra food, a melting plant, a fertilizing session that went just a bit too heavy. These don't seem like big moments, but algae notices them immediately. A 2019 freshwater biology paper showed that nutrient spikes, even short ones, caused algae blooms far more often than steady, moderate nutrient levels. Plants can't adapt fast enough. Algae can. If nutrients jump suddenly, algae appears suddenly. Cause number three, flow dead zones. Behind driftwood, under rocks, between thick plants, anywhere water stops moving. These pockets trap waste and create low oxygen zones that algae loves. Stagnation is one of the fastest bloom triggers because it shuts down the beneficial microbes that normally outcompete algae. Fix the flow, fix the biofilm, and the algae disappears on its own. Cause number four, overcleaning. This one surprises people. Scrubbing every rock, washing the filter until it's spotless, vacuuming gravel like you're looking for buried treasure. It feels productive, but it destroys the very microbial community that keeps algae under control. Biofilm isn't dirt, it's protection. A stabilizing layer of beneficial bacteria and microfauna. A 2018 microbial ecology study found that tanks with stable biofilm had higher shrimp survival, more otocinclus feeding activity, and significantly lower algae growth. If you remove old biofilm, algae becomes the first organism to grow back. Cause number five, microbial disruption. Huge water changes, cleaning filters in tap water, deep substrate stirring. Every time you shake the tank's microbiome, plants take days to recover. Algae takes minutes. Microbes are slow. Algae is fast. That's why unstable tanks always have more algae, even if the parameters look perfect. So what do I fix? The real solution. If you take one thing from this video, let it be this. Algae isn't the plant problem. It's an ecosystem imbalance. Fix the environment, and the algae disappears without you even targeting it. And yes, if you want the cleanup crew that actually works, watch our previous video, Best Algae Eaters That Really Help. But only after you fix the causes. Algae eaters are support, not a cure. Now let's talk about the myths that cause the worst mistakes. Mites, what beginners keep getting wrong about algae. Myth number one, algae means your tank is dirty. This is the most common misunderstanding in the entire hobby. Algae doesn't show up because your tank is dirty, it shows up because your tank is unstable. And here's the science. A 2019 study in freshwater microbial dynamics showed that algae blooms were strongly correlated with sudden environmental shifts, not the overall waste level. Meaning, you can have a spotless tank with unstable light or flow, and algae will show up anyway. Or you can have a naturally busy tank with stable routines and hardly see any algae at all. Algae responds to change, not to dirt. Myth number two, high light is the main cause of algae. Not exactly. High light doesn't cause algae by itself. Inconsistent light does. Plants and beneficial microbes adjust their metabolism slowly over hours or even days. Algae adjusts in minutes. A 2020 analysis in Journal of Aquatic Botany found that light fluctuations, even small ones, trigger immediate algal activity long before plants can react. So it's not the brightness, it's the instability. If your lights, curtains, window reflections, or schedules keep changing day to day, algae will always win the race. Myth number three, zero nitrates equals zero algae. This one sounds logical, and it destroys more tanks than it fixes. Plants need nitrogen to survive. Starve them long enough and they stop growing altogether. When plants shut down, algae steps in because algae can thrive on scraps. A study in Hydrobiologia, 2017, showed that nitrate-poor environments reduce plant growth but do not slow algae reproduction. In some cases, algae growth increased because plants were no longer competing. Zero nitrates doesn't prevent algae. It removes the only thing keeping algae in check. Bonus science truths, the stuff beginners never hear about. Bonus truth number one, algae reacts faster than plants. This is the root of all algae problems. Plants need time to adapt. They adjust slowly to new light, new nutrients, and new environmental rhythms. But algae, algae reacts instantly. A 2017 study by Shaver and colleagues demonstrated that plant metabolic adaptation lags hours behind algal response under identical conditions. So whenever you change something suddenly, light intensity, flow, fertilizing routines, photoperiod, algae takes advantage of that gap. That small window is the birthplace of most algae blooms. Bonus truth number two, uneven flow creates microscopic algae hotspots. You can have good flow overall and still have algae problems because algae thrives in the small dead zones your eyes never notice. Behind a stone, under a piece of driftwood, under a dense plant leaf canopy, those micro pockets trap nutrients and debris that algae uses as a launching pad. A 2020 flow microhabitat study found algae colonized stagnant pockets 10 times faster than well-circulated areas. It's not about blasting the whole tank with high flow. It's about eliminating the tiny pockets where algae breeds in peace. Bonus. Truth number three, overcleaning does more damage than undercleaning. This one shocks beginners. The thin biofilm layer on your decor and glass is not dirt. It's the immune system of your aquarium. A 2018 microbial ecology study showed that stable biofilm communities reduce algal colonization by crowding out early algal cells. When you scrub everything to look brand new, you remove the natural competition that keeps algae suppressed. It looks clean for a day, and then algae blooms harder than before because nothing is stopping it anymore. Stable biofilm equals stable tank. If your tank has ever gone through an algae phase, that made you question every decision you've ever made in this hobby. Trust me, you're not alone. Algae is frustrating, but it's also one of the best teachers you'll ever have. Every bloom tells you something about your light, your flow, your nutrients, or your microbial balance. Once you learn to read those signals, your tank becomes dramatically easier to manage. If you want the next step toward crystal clear, stable aquariums, don't miss the companion video link below. Best algae eaters that really help. It completes this entire system and shows you exactly which grazes strengthen the balance we talked about today. Until next time, keep your light steady, your microbes happy, and your curiosity flowing.